If you've ever used the crop to shape feature in Microsoft Word or PowerPoint, it's a really neat feature that lets you take an image and crop it into a shape, like if you want to take a portrait and make it into a circle. In fact, I have another video on my channel that shows you how you can use this feature, so be sure and check that out. But let's say that you have cropped your image into an arrow shape, and then you want to rotate that arrow to point the other way. The image inside that shape also gets rotated. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can fix that so that you can insert an image into a shape, rotate that shape without rotating the image inside. Let's take a look. All right, let's go ahead and recreate the issue that we have when we crop an image to a shape in PowerPoint. I have a blank PowerPoint presentation. I'm going to come up to Insert, Pictures, From This Device. I'm going to navigate to an image that I want to insert and click on Insert. And I close out. Sometimes design ideas pop up on the right. I'm just gonna close that window. And then I'm going to drag and resize this image to make it a little bit smaller. Now I have that image selected, so I'm gonna come up to the picture format area and then click on crop. Crop to shape. And then I'm going to select an arrow. This crops that image into an arrow. And as you can see, I can drag that anywhere on my slide. And if I hover on the rotation handle, if I click and rotate that image, notice that the image inside also rotates. And so we want to prevent that from happening. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and hit delete. So we'll delete that. And instead of cropping the image to a shape, what I wanna do is insert the shape first, and then we will bring the picture into that shape. So let's go up to Insert, Shapes, and I'm gonna click on the arrow here, and then I'm gonna draw that arrow with my mouse by clicking and dragging, and then I'm going to right click and select Format Shape. On the fill, I'm gonna drop down, and instead of a solid fill, I'm gonna select Picture or Texture Fill. And then from there, I can click on Insert, From a File, and I can select that same image if I want to use that and click on Insert. And now it inserts the image into my shape, and I can resize that shape however I want to. Now I'm going to come over here to the Format Picture area, and I'm going to scroll down, and notice down here there's a box that's automatically checked that says Rotate with Shape. So I'm going to uncheck that box. And so we're going to want to uncheck that, and then notice when we come over to the rotation handle, if we rotate this shape, so if we want the arrow to point the other direction, we can rotate the shape, and the image inside does not rotate with that shape. So that's how we can fix that issue. And then if we want to down here, we can expand under line. If we don't want to have a line around that shape, we can just say no line. And so there you have a way. If you wanted to, you could hit Control C to copy and Control V to paste. And maybe you wanted to have two different arrows that were pointing in different directions on your slide with the image staying upright. You can do that. The same works in Microsoft Word. So if we go on over to Microsoft Word and just open up a blank document, we can insert a shape. We're going to go up to Shapes, and we can select the arrow and draw an arrow here in Microsoft Word, right click, Format Shape, come up to Picture or Texture Fill. Now, since I had already inserted that image, it automatically inserted it. If I wanted to change that and have a different image, all I have to do is change the picture source over here by clicking Insert, and then selecting a different photo to include. And then down here is that checkbox that I can uncheck saying Rotate with Shape, and I can say No Line. And I can come over and rotate my arrow without rotating the image inside. I wanted to let you guys know about Super Thanks. It's a thanks button that you'll see below the videos on my channel. And if you want to donate to my channel, you can click on that button, and all of your donations go towards supporting and creating videos like this for the channel. Really appreciate all of your support. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it. You can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.